Learning outcome number four, understanding what are the impact of low and high quality information towards an organization. How can we define a low quality information? On figure 6.4, we can see an examples of low quality information. Number one, missing an information in terms of the customer name. Number two, incomplete information. You can see that the address is not complete. Number three, there are a duplication of an information because maybe of the error when entering the information in the reports. Number four, a wrong information when it comes to the fax numbers and phone numbers. Number five, inaccurate information, which is invalid email. And number six, incomplete information in terms of missing all the postcode numbers for the home addresses. What are the causes of low quality information? There are four primary sources of low quality information. Number one, which is online customers purposely or intentionally, secara sengaja, enter inaccurate information about themselves because maybe to protect their privacy. Examples like giving a fake name, fake account numbers. Number two, information from different systems have their different entry standards and formats. This involves when organizations have a different system, which is one system, kind of an old system, and the another system might be the new system. Number three, when call center operators enter abbreviated or erroneous information by accident or to save their time. Examples like when your name is Muhammad, the operators just key in a shorter version of Muhammad. And number four, the information that the organization get from the third party, maybe from another organization, consists of inaccuracy of the information itself. So this will lead to errors and also will lead to the cost of low and poor information that can be collected by the organizations. Number one, unable for the organization to accurately track their customers. It is difficult for the organization to identify who is the valuable customers. And this also could affect the opportunities of selling the products towards their customers. And an organization might end up selling or do a marketing to non-existent customers. Organizations are difficult to track their profits because of the inaccurate invoices, and then also unable to build a strong relationship with their customers. And finally, of course, when organization have a high quality information, it actually helps the organization to make better decisions in terms of how to maintain a good relationship with their customers, how to have a good link with their suppliers, how well the organization could manage the strategies and able to maintain their performance in the current market. With high quality information also, an organization are able to make a solid strategic organization decisions because they have the knowledge and they have the correct information to make a correct decisions. As a conclusion, poor information will lead to poor decisions and high quality of information will lead to a good decisions.